Angler's Mail is today visiting the Exeter Canal, and this is for our Where to Fish This Weekend segment in the magazine. This fishery is run by the Exeter and District Angling Association, and I'm actually on the lime kilns today, which is a stretch between the double locks and turf. This is probably the best known part of the canal in actual fact. It's certainly its widest part, and anything up to about 70 yards across here, I guess it must be. The wall which I'm standing on is probably the most favoured spot here, especially this time of year. We're in kind of very early spring at the moment, and there's a lot of anglers come down here and target the tench and the bream this time of year, because they tend to shoal up here in the very early kind of spring, or even late winter, February, March time. There's four guys here at the moment, and they're actually struggling a bit today. It's been a very cold night. Although the guy second down actually fished overnight, and he's a very brave man, I must say, with temperatures down to about -2. But he actually caught a few fish at about 3-4 o'clock in the morning. So if you fancy that, which must admit I don't, you could try that maybe, an overnighter down here. Normally, I mean, I fished this place the last 2 or 3 years for the tench, and mostly it's kind of, I found afternoons were quite good actually. No need to get here at the crack of dawn really. And had plenty of fish in the kind of afternoons and evenings. Tench don't get massive in it. I mean, you hear the occasional claim of kind of 8-9 pound fish, but I mean, the best one I've had so has been about 7. But if you can find them, you can certainly catch quite a few. There's multiple catches taken down here quite frequently. There's also some nice bream in here. I've had them up to about 8 pound. People claim bigger. Certainly some very good pike in the Exeter Canal. They go up, well, there's been 30s caught in the past. I don't know whether they're still in here, but most years you hear of 20s being caught. Certainly lots of nice kind of roach and rudd as well. In fact, the rudd at times can be a bit of a nightmare on the, when you're maggot fishing with for the tench and the bream. They can be slightly overpowering, if you like. But certainly a very productive fishery this day, especially, as I say, this time of year. It's amazing. I'm here in late February, and I say there's plenty of tench and bream to be caught down here this time of year. I think today is a bit sunny and bright, to be honest. You prefer to have a nice kind of cloudy day with a bit of chop on the water, but no, it's certainly worth a visit this time of year, and later. I mean, it gets a bit weedy in the summertime, but you rake a swim out, you should be able to get a few tench and bream. This is Paul Hamilton reporting for Angler's Mail. You can read more about this fishery in the magazine, along with many others that we feature every week, or visit our website at www.anglersmail.co.uk.